Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at choruses. A chorus is an effect that's designed to sort of increase the breadth of the sound or increase the richness of the sound. It kind of comes by doubling the sound, but changing the frequency dynamically of one of the inputs. Originally, this would have been done in an analog world with two audio sources, like these two tape recorders, to produce a kind of chorus or a flanger effect. The two outputs from the tape recorder, imagine that there was the same signal on both, were added together. But manually, you could adjust the speed of one of the tape recorders, just varying it ever so slightly, and you'll get that kind of flanging or chorusing effect. In our digital world, we'll do a similar thing. We'll have an audio input, which will go directly to the output. A copy of it will also go through a delay. We will use an LFO, low frequency oscillator, to vary the delay time, and that will vary the pitch of this delayed signal. And we'll do that sort of very subtly, and then mix it together, and that will cause our chorusing effect. So let's have a go at building that. So we need a signal of some sort to play, so we'll start by creating a phaser. This will give us a kind of triangular a sawtooth waveform, but it's a unipolar signal, so we'll need to just adjust that so that it becomes a bipolar signal. So we multiply by 2, so it goes between 0 and 2, and then we subtract 1 to bring it down to the range from negative 1 to 1. So that will produce a sawtooth waveform for us. What we want to do is to send that waveform to a buffer. So we're going to use the delay right tilde object, and we'll set up a buffer. I'm going to call it $0. Buffer, and it doesn't need to be very big. I'll just make it 100 milliseconds long. So there's our sound source. We need to be able to listen back to that sound source, of course. So let's do here a delay, del read 4 tilde object. So this will read back, and we need to tell it which buffer to read back from. And that will be our buffer object, and that should be enough. So this is very similar to the process, or exactly the same actually, as a process we would have done for a simple delay. And if we put a volume control in here, we can give that volume control value between 0 and 1. So pass that through the volume control, and then put digital analog converter at the end so we can hear it back. Connect that up to left and right. Give us a little bit of volume, and there you can hear we have our signal. You can see it on our oscilloscope. It's being written out to a buffer, and we're reading it back directly from that buffer with effectively no delay at this stage by default. So what we need to do is we need to modulate this delay time so that we get a change in the frequency of that buffered signal. So we'll do that by using an oscillator, which will produce like a sine tone or a cosine wave. We need to make sure that that's only got a very small pitch value, so I'm going to create a control for that up here so we can vary its frequency. We don't need to make that frequency very large, so I'm going to make it maybe go from 0 up to 2. And so that will just be a very slow oscillator, low frequency oscillator. What we want from this oscillator is the opposite we wanted for this phasor, which is it is a bipolar signal, and we really want to make it a unipolar polar signal so that it goes between 0 and 1. That's because it's going to affect our delay buffer reading point, and 0 is at the beginning of our buffer, and we want to increase above that. We never want to go into the negative part of the buffer because that doesn't actually exist. So I need to use an expression object in order to fix that as well. So we get the input, we add 1 to it, and then divide by 2, and that will make our oscillator into a unipolar oscillator. All right, so at the moment, this will go between 0 and 1. If we plug this in, it will not really have any audible effect. Because all we're really doing is changing our signal by 1 hertz, which is pretty close to inaudible. So we'll need to increase the amplitude of that so that we can increase the depth. So we'll use a amplifier to do that, and we'll provide a value for that amplified signal. So we need to amplify that signal. We'll turn our LFO up to some amount, just close to 1 hertz, turn up our volume, and then as we increase this amplitude, you can hear that we are affecting the delay read head, moving it forward and back through the buffer, and the effect of that is to change the frequency of our playback. So that's how we're getting the variable sine. We don't need in our chorus effect for it to go quite that high. We want a much more subtle effect, but that just shows you what we can do. Another thing is that when this goes back to zero, it will be back in phase with the direct signal, and that won't be exactly what we want. We really never want it to get in phase, and we want it to stay out of phase and just increase and decrease. So we are going to put a little offset in here. So the offset will be provided with the plus tilde object, and for the minute I might even just set that offset directly. That shouldn't make much difference. Let's have a listen. Yep, okay, so that's all still working. Okay, so we've got our delayed signal, which is being modulated. We want, of course, to have the original signal. So I'm going to read the signal a second time, and this time pass it directly into this amplifier. So we've got the direct signal, and we've got the signal which is being modulated. So let's listen to that. And then increase the amount of modulation. And voila, we have our chorusing effect. We can decrease the amount of chorusing there and increase the amount of chorusing as we go. So there's ways in which we can finesse that, and we can turn our chorusing into a stereo chorus with another kind of tranche of doing the same thing and separating the channels out and so forth. But in effect, there we have our stereo, we have our mono chorus. In order to add this to your projects, you would just replace this sawtooth oscillator with some other sound source or some synthesis process, and then pass it through the rest of the chain, so you add the chorus to the rest of your signal. Okay, see you in the next video.